Grace Eyre is behind Rethink Disability, a short film that educates to see abilities before disabilities. I was at the screening at the Comedia, where I spoke with the director of this Brighton-based charity, one of the oldest and most innovative in the UK, committed to support people with learning disability, autism and or mental health issues. I also spoke with the former world record holder Paralympic athlete John Harris and two people involved in the project. If you want to know more, donate or volunteer is www.graceeyre.org.
Grace Eyre is a local charity here in Brighton that supports people with learning disabilities and autism. We run projects, we support people with housing, employment, day activities, and really enhancing people's lives and supporting them to live as independently as possible.
My name's John Harris. I'm a Paralympic athlete. I don't think you should say former, I'm just a Paralympic athlete. Competed in 5 Olympic Games, winner of Olympic gold, silver, bronze, subject of This Is Your Life. I climbed Kilimanjaro.
Amazing. So this rethinking campaign, obviously, like, you're mainly directly affected by how people look at people with some disability. How do you think people should change their perspective on?
I think it's really difficult to change people's attitudes. I've always said there isn't a great deal you can do about racists and bigots. You know, the rest is about education, and I think that's all it is. And by having films like this, this educates people, and as many people that can see this film and see the positive attitudes, hopefully, and I haven't seen the films yet, but see the positive attitudes that come out from the people with disabilities in the film, I think that's a great step forward, I think.
So have you seen a change in attitude in the last decades or so?
Oh, when I first had my accident, I'm going back to 1964, I was refused entry into restaurants, buses, cinemas. You could, I think Pontins had a policy back in the day that disabled people could only go to their holiday camps certain time of the year because it wouldn't affect other people there, wouldn't affect the non-disabled. So I've seen quite a bit over the years, and I've seen some fantastically positive things that have taken place as well. Still a long way to go, still a long way, but I think we're heading in the right direction, and it's all about good people. And there are more good people than there are bad. And I people like Jenny now, Wolf, as soon as she hit the room, you know, she's crazy, like, you know. And I think people like that will make a massive difference.
Great. So where are we and what's happening today?
Today, we've got the launch of our Rethink Disability campaign, which is asking people to rethink about when they see a person with disability and to recognise the ability that everyone has. It's trying to sort of show that everyone's the same. And we're doing this today through showing 3 short films, all based on the theme of ability. And these show the talent of a lot of the people we support. So there's a short film on our employment project, there's a film on the Rethink Disability campaign itself, and there's another film from Shania, who's a University of Sussex film student as well. And she's done a beautiful film about the activities that we run at Grace Eyre and the beauty of people within.
My name's Stuart Leaney.
And you're one of the main actors.
I play the main character, Alex. Yeah.
How was it?
Really good.
So tell me about your experience. Have you acting before?
I've never acted before, but this is my first time I've actually acted really in a film.
Ever since I met Grace Eyre, I've had more opportunities to, you know, engage with a community. So it's been an excellent experience.
And you just told me that they developed a side of you that was unknown before.
That's right. I mean, due to my dyspraxia, I've had struggles with getting jobs, struggles with many everyday things. Ever since I met Grace Eyre, they've given me a platform where I can express myself, and it's not disability, it's ability.
So tell me about the story of the film.
It's basically what happens is Alex loses his job because he's too slow. And then he goes for an interview, but they keep turning him away because of his disability. And they don't give him a chance. But in the end, he becomes a DJ through the Grace Eyre organisation.
Would you like to talk about the process, how those films came about?
Yeah, certainly. We run a group called the Friendship Group, which is an online community of people who get together, which has really got massive over lockdown. That it used to have about 100 people in it, and now it's like 500 to 600 people. And they sort of get together, do activities like yoga, painting, gardening, all online, and well, now actually some in person as well, now that we've been allowed to do that. And one of the people said, why do people see us as being disabled? Because everyone has a disability. Just because ours are more visible doesn't mean that we should be labelled as disabled. We all have abilities too, so why can't we just be called able people? So this is how the sort of campaign developed. We made the film first, and then we liked it so much that we used the Rethink sort of concept to ask people to rethink about how they see people with disability and to lose the dis. Don't diss the ability, really. So
I suppose a couple of the things that I have done, and I've been pretty fortunate. I was able to push twice around Wales. I pushed 400 miles in 11 days, and I pushed 600 miles in 37 days, 18 miles every day for 37 days with a great friend of mine called Chris Allam, another Paralympian. And again, that was to raise awareness, but also to raise as much money as we possibly could to build a sports centre for the disabled, which wasn't around at that particular time. The only time disabled people could kind of go to a leisure centre was normally on a Sunday afternoon, about 1 o'clock, 1:30, when everyone was having lunch, so disabled could go there. So things have changed quite a bit, you know, and again, for me, to drive 185 miles down to Brighton, it must be quite important. And an event like this is extremely important, and the benefit I hope that disabled people will reap from it will be something a little bit special. Yes.
That's fantastic. And you say you're a music composer?
I'm also a composer of music and music production. I've actually got a website, www.dombeatbox.co.uk. So if you guys want to check that out, you'll find some of my music there. I've actually done a jazzy a cappella on there. And since working with Grace Eyre, I was actually credited on the music side of things, where they incorporated my music as a soundbed for the after fact.
Them to see as equal, as human beings, as people just as we are, with you know, aspirations and talents. And really, so people look beyond disability and see the ability that people do have. There's a campaign out at the moment, and it's on all Brighton and Hove buses. So one in every four buses have got the Rethink Disability poster. So we're hoping to get the message out to people to stop and think about how they treat people with disability, because these are really talented people who've got so much to give.
So do you reflect yourself in the character you played?
Yeah. I feel emotional watching the character as well.
So, what would you think the people will think when they watch the film?
They would think that it's good for me to stand up for people, disabled people's rights, really.